Justice Simon Mujeni Byabakama, Mother Electoral Commission boss, has called for peace and transparency ahead of the Dokolo by election tomorrow.
Business of people, you know, behaving like there's no tomorrow, like the Uganda is ending with that process of elections, we should really change our mindset and our tact in the way we look at things and do them. The people came, so many people came in from outside Dokolo to support or drum up support for their various candidates. Was there any problem? No.
He said the Electoral Commission will do its utmost to ensure that election materials reach the polling station as soon as possible. He assured the people of a free and fair election.
We strongly urge the voters to turn up early at their respective polling stations so that polling starts early on time, that is by 7 a.m. As a commission, we have put in place all the necessary preparations to ensure that materials are delivered as early as possible at the 173 polling stations, so that by 7 a.m. polling starts.
However, some UPC members, led by the party secretary, have punched holes in the security ahead of the election.
In other places, they are already pre-ticked and staffed, like in the Ijeoma Town Council. So, this night, allow us to have those people who are going to help the commission.
The chairperson of the NRM Party Electoral Commission, Dr. Tang Odoi, has responded to these allegations, saying that arrests have been made as some people were found bribing voters.
So no amount of intimidation will work against us, but we shall keep the law. Even chairman went to raid and we thanked the police officer for a new one. These are your forces. It's not a political party that brings political officers here. I mean the police officers. They are actually your staff.
The Eastern Region Police spokesperson, Jimmy Patrick Okema, promised to ensure the smooth running of the elections. Speaking about the arrest of people for allegedly bribing voters, which was one of the main issues discussed today, he said they would continue to investigate those who bribe voters, assuring Dokolo residents that everything will go smoothly.
It's true, we have got some of them with a lump sum of money, trying to distribute money, which is of course against the electoral laws. So it is being handled case by case as it comes. Even right now, we've just got a call to one of the other sub-county and we are following it closely. We want people to be very much vigilant and be reporting these cases by case to us so that we are able to handle them.
The election materials have already been delivered to Dokolo District Headquarters by the District Electoral Officer Eric Ngobi, who confirmed that they all arrived in good condition.
We are verifying, we are releasing them. Let them go and continue. We have noted they are coming from wherever. But my question is, who are those who are arresting them and bringing them to police? If you go to know that there are other classified security personnel who, among other things, execute clandestine arrests without the cards, whether they are observers or what, it would be important.
This was confirmed by the agents of the candidates. Polling day for the district man representative to parliament and other local government councillors will be conducted tomorrow, Thursday, 21st March 2024, and six candidates are to battle for this seat. The district woman representative seat for Dokolo became vacant following the death of the former representative, the late Honorable Cecilia Atimo Gwal, who died on 18th January 2024. Report compiled by Abdul Mwonge for the news.